Hi, Todd here from Goshen, Carnage, and today I'm going to be talking about the die rotor. Just to start off, this hopper is a little pricey. You can buy them new for, I think, 160 or 170, depending on what color you want. I actually bought this for 150 plus my mounting bag. Kind of like, this fused too, so it was kind of like, I needed it though, because my mag kind of broke on me. So,
an awful deal.
Yeah. It sits low to the gun, as you can see. Just like the Prophecy or any of them would. Any of the really good hoppers sit really low to the gun. Alright, very easy to take apart. Open the lid. Open up the tab that I opened with the lid. Button in. Lift up the back, and it just comes right off the top. From here.
Take off more, yeah.
From here, there's a tab right there. You're just going to push that forward, and the back pops up. Out comes the back. Batteries are in there, strapped in. In here, to take this out, you just flip open these two little red tabs and come right out. Not going to go much further than that because I kind of got a time limit on this. So.
Not really, we got a lot of time.
Make sure it still works, it's not hitting. If it hits, I'll do this just, I hate when it does this, but I'll do it just for the purpose of you seeing. When it hits, that's what happens. You gotta make sure it goes under that tab. Ace, you might want to zoom in on that.
Yeah, not me.
This tab right here, you gotta make sure this blood piece goes under the tab. Like that, sits under that. Gotta repeat.
No, we don't. Okay, fine, repeat.
Batteries, simple. Anything else? And put it back together. Slide this front under the two tabs. And push down in the back, and just snaps into place. And then the front, tab locks in, push to the back, tab goes down.
Yeah, and if you guys didn't notice, he's already got a speed feed on it.
I do have a speed feed. Actually, I don't sell a speed feed right now. I'm not going to do it, I'll just explain how to do it. Very easy. Unscrew all those five screws. Alright.
Five screws? Oh, yeah.
When you're done with that, this top part should just pop right out. And you're going to need like a tiny screwdriver or a tiny hex head to push out the pin that holds the lid on, which is like sits right in here. You might not be able to actually see it a little bit. You can actually see it through there. There's a pin in there.
Yeah.
And then the hopper, the lid will just come right out. And this virtue cutting does come with a pin, so you just slide this one right in. And pretty much stays in, like, see? That's it for the Virtue Crown. Really easy installation. Took me probably about like less than 5 minutes to do. Drop test. I know you guys have probably seen the other video of the Pinocchio versus Rotor and stuff, but I'm gonna do just a single one just so you're only paying attention to this. That's a bad idea.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, that was a really bad idea.
I don't really care.
Alright. Just let it go.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright, so the record for this at the time on my phone was 3.7 seconds for 140 rounds. So we'll try to beat that right now. I'm not going to time it, but you'll just tell. And hopefully it won't jam. There's... Ready? I'm up.
There we go.
And that's it, very fast. I was able to play with this at West Point for a day and maybe a half. Did jam on me like two or three times. Didn't like that, but it does have this nice anti-jam right there.
Yeah, I like that. I like that a lot.
No, I'll just leave this lid off for now. You can see it, orange.
Yeah.
What else can I say? Can't really...
How was it? Like, what's the overall rating?
9 out of 10. I would have received a 10 if it didn't jam, but... jam, so...